So, in previous videos, we have been talking about fossil fuels, right? And what is the non-desirable effects of fossil fuels. So, we saw that one of the effect was that it is limited. It may have much more availability, but the methods to extract them are limited, and therefore extracting in a cost-effective manner puts the constraint on the total available capacity from these renewable sources, right? The other thing was the method by which it is extracted. Now that method is also harmful, and I've shared you a few examples of that. Third thing was pollution, right? So it has consequences on health due to increasing pollution. Now, one of the major factor and which a lot of people think while we are using fossil fuel is climate change. So, in this video, let us see a little bit more about, or rather, the basics of climate change. Right. So, yeah, starts with the fossil. So, the first step is we extract these fossils and then we purify them. Right, we bring them to a usable shape, and then we use those fossils to power the industries, transportation, and produce electricity in power plants. In process of doing these activities, all three of them, we end up emitting gases such as sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides, carbon dioxide, and so on. We earlier saw the harmful effects of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides. So carbon dioxide, if you see, is one of the major contributor to this climate change equation. How does it contribute to the equation? CO2 is very long-lived, right? It does not go away from the environment very fast. It can be added very fast. So if you burn a fuel and so on, it gets added very quickly, but removing it takes enormous amount of time. So if you see, as of now, it's about 390 part per million, right? Used to be about 280 ppm pre-industrial era. And if you see, industrialization has been predominantly established on the platform of fossil fuels. And that has led to a significant increase in the carbon dioxide in the environment. As I mentioned, it's very long-lived. CO2 is much more long-lived than any other gas. The reason is that CO2 is emitted by fossil fuels and it is absorbed by the sea or the water bodies. And that absorption is very, very slow. And therefore, even if we add little bit of carbon dioxide now, it takes enormous amount of years for it to get absorbed in by the sea. And thus, the level of carbon dioxide is continuously increasing. Somehow, if we are able to, let's say, we are able to come to a conclusion and we stop adding any more new power plants or any more transportation, any more industries which are powered by fossil fuels, still the current emission of the CO2 is large enough, which will continue to rise, which will continue to create adverse effect on the climate. And we'll see how. So CO2, as we understand, is one of the greenhouse effect gas, right? So it absorbs the radiation and it increases the overall temperature of the earth. Now, as temperature increases, it also increases water vapor, right? Which also has a greenhouse effect and which further increases the temperature, right? So this is just a small cycle which or rather a positive feedback kind of mechanism which happens here. So what happens if the temperature increases? If the temperature of the air increases because of CO2, then slowly the temperature of water bodies including sea also increases. But that process is much slower because of the large heat absorbing capacity of the water. And that is one of the reasons you would feel that even though the ambient temperature or the air temperature might change very quickly, the water temperature takes more time to change. As the water temperature would increase, the ice would melt. As the ice would melt, again, that would be a slow process. As slowly ice would melt, then the overall water would increase, and then some of the land masses might get submerged. If you see the time constant of this whole process, it is in hundreds to thousands of years, right? It's very, very slow. So imagine that right now I have taken a piece of coal, or I take a car and I drive it for a kilometer. It emits some gases, right? Now, if it emits some amount of small amount of CO2, then that particular CO2 would remain in the air for thousands of years, right? CO2 would have the effect on the climate for next thousands of years. You imagine if you have a system which has a very small time constant, you give it a step input, right? And if you observe the output, because the time constant is so slow, the output will increase very slowly, right? And if you observe it for a year or 2 years, you may feel that that step input might not really have much impact because the output has grown only very small amount of fraction. But because the time constant is so large, you would see that the output will respond to that step after, let's say, thousands of years, right? So the step still has the same impact, and in fact, it can have impact much more. But then if you only observe it for a couple of years, we are not really able to figure out the impact of that step input. I've taken this picture from one of the source. If you see this sort of really shows us what is happening. This is the blue line shows the carbon dioxide emission. So even if, let's say, in terms of emission, we stop emitting, or we rather start reduce the emission of CO2, right? In next 10-15 years, we have all realized it's not good, and we start reducing the CO2 emission. And in about 100 years, we have reduced it a little bit. Another maybe 200, 300, 400 years, we are able to bring it down to a very good level, the emission part. If you see the overall carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, because the absorption is so slow, that the overall carbon dioxide stabilizes in about 100 to 300 years to this value. Because of that, the temperature stabilizes in a few centuries. The sea level rises due to this thermal expansion another few centuries to millennia. And then the sea level rises due to ice melt several millennia. So you can imagine how this, a small CO2 that we are producing now, even if we try to curtail it in next 100, 200 years, that would have a long lasting impact, right? So this shows the gravity of the situation. And the only reason we do not, some of us may not consider it to be a big problem is because the time constant is very slow. So you may not see this phenomena as happening in this life, but that does not mean that the change is happening. Now, that said, this was the basic climate change cycle, right? The most basic version of it. There are enormous number of things happen around that. Just to give you a few example, let's say there is because of the emission of gases in the environment, it increases the acidic content. So if carbon dioxide gets absorbed in the water, the sea acidic content also increases, which might affect the ecosystem of the sea. Similarly, the ice is melting, so the salt level in the sea reduces, which affects the thermohaline water movement of the sea, which is another effect which has. And there are a lot of other effects which happen with this basic cycle at place. Right? So yeah, there are a lot of things happening, and the only thing, as I told you before, everything is happening with a slower time constant, and therefore we tend to neglect it, but we should not be doing that. Sure, all of us on a lighter side would have seen the movie Ice Age and Continental Drift, and where you see, which sort of gives you a picture of what happens. And that is now, how do we avoid this situation, right? As we understand, we can avoid this situation by shifting to non-fossil fuel based generation, shifting to renewable generation as soon as possible, right? And that's where more about that we are going to talk in this course on polytronic converters for renewable energy.